Hi everyone, I'm Aria and I hope you're doing well. If you've seen my videos before, welcome back. And if you're new to the channel and you like my work, please consider subscribing. Today we're going to be creating these two animations using the free molecular script add-on, which adds particle collisions as well as particle linking. Alright, so here we go. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is follow the link in the description here to download the molecular script add-on here, and you can just click whatever one applies to you and download to your hard drive. And then once you've got that downloaded, you can open up a new scene in Blender, and if you go to Edit, Preferences, and go to Add-ons, you can go to Install, and then just find where the zip file is saved on your computer, and you can click that and click Install Add-on. Then once the installation is complete, it should show up, or you can just type in molecular here and then just make sure this is turned on. Alright, so now we can just select the camera and the light here and hit delete. We're going to use the default cube for our ground plane, so let's hit S to scale, Z to lock it to the Z axis, and then we'll type in 0.1. And then hit enter, and then the next thing we can do is hit S to scale, and then we'll hit Shift Z to lock it to the Y and X axis only, and then we can type in 12 and hit enter again. Next, we'll hit Shift A to add a new mesh. Let's click Torus, then S5 to scale it by 5. Then we're going to hit G to move it, Z to lock to that axis, and we can hit 4. Next, hit the decimal key to orbit around our sphere here. We can then hit Tab to go into edit mode, or you can click here and go to edit mode like that. And now we just want to grab some of the faces at the bottom here. So let's just hide the cube for a minute by clicking this little icon here. And we can just twirl underneath here. Let's hit 3 on the keyboard to go into face select mode. Or you can just click here. Hold Alt and we're going to select this face here to select that entire loop. Shift Alt and then we can just click here to select that second loop there. And then we can just hit 1 to go into front orthographic view. Let's hit E, and then we can just drag the mouse straight down. And you can see the blue line indicates that we have it locked to the Z axis. So let's just put that level with the ground here. Then we can hit S, Z, and type in 0 to scale that to flatten the bottom. And then we're just going to hit Control R, and you'll see this guide comes up here. We can just click and drag all the way down. We're just going to add a couple extra edge loops, which will help our geometry look a little bit nicer once we subdivide it. And then we'll just go underneath. And we'll do that again right here and here as well. You can also do the inside if you want, but it's not super necessary, so just one there. Control R again and just drag it down to here. Alright, so now that we've got that, we can hit Tab to go back into Object Mode, or again you can go here and select Object Mode. Let's right click and Shade Smooth. Go over here to the Modifiers tab, click here, and we can go to Subdivision Surface and set this to 2 or 3. Alright, now we can unhide the cube, and then let's just click it, hit G, Z, and hold Shift, and then we can just drag down till it's just underneath of our torus, and then we can click. And then finally we're going to add our mesh for our particles, so hit Shift A, let's go to Mesh, and hit Plane. And then we can hit G, Z, and 7 to move it up on the Z axis. Next, let's hit S to scale it, and we can type in 8.6. And now we're ready to add our particle system. So let's go over to Particles here, and we can hit the plus to add a new particle system. Let's leave the number as it is, and let's set the start frame to 1 and the end frame to 1 as well. Let's go back to frame 1 here so that we can see our simulation properly. Now we can set the lifetime to the length of our animation, so 250. Next, we'll open the source tabs here. We can leave it from faces, but let's change it from jitter to grid. And you'll see right away that it gets rid of the number option here. And we're going to use the resolution instead. So type in 100. And we can just scroll down now. We're not going to use these cache settings here today because we're going to use the molecular script add-on. So we can just forget about this for this animation. Next, scroll down to deflection here and we're going to hit size deflect. And basically what that will do is instead of having the particles deflected from the center of the sphere, it will be from the outer edge instead. Alright, next we'll go to the render tab here and we're going to switch from halo to object, and you can see that that gets rid of our guides here, so let's add a particle. Hit Shift A and we can go to mesh and click icosphere, and then we just want to hit GX to bring it out of our scene here. We can right click and shade smooth, go to our modifiers tab, click here and add a subdivision surface, and one or two should work fine. Okay, so now we can click back on our plane here. Let's go back into the Particles tab here. You can scroll all the way down. And then we can click here and select Icosphere for our object. And so now if we click away, you'll see that they're fairly small. So let's change the scale here to 0.1. And if you're following my exact measurements, this should work fine. The idea is just to get them intersecting just a little bit. All right, then we can uncheck Show Emitter here. Let's scroll down and go to Viewport Display, and we'll also uncheck Show Emitter here as well. And now we can scroll all the way down to the bottom here, and you'll see this new option here called Molecular. So let's turn that on, and we can open up the settings here. Let's open up the Simulate option here, and basically what this is our cache settings here. So you can see that we've got our start and end frame, our substeps, and you can also set the amount of CPU cores being used. Alright, so we want to set the substeps to something like 8 or 10, as high as your system can handle. If you can go up even higher, it'll work better. If you are too low, you'll find that your particles will look very jittery when they're moving around. So the higher you can set these, the better. Alright, so now we can skip density for now. Let's go to collisions here, and we're going to click activate self-collision. We can leave this unchecked. Basically, this is if you're using two different particle systems and you want them to interact with each other. And then we can leave these two default settings here. Let's open up links, and we're going to activate particle linking. And the same thing here, because we're not using more than one particle system, we can just leave this unchecked. Let's open both of these properties here, and we can make a few different settings here. And most of these are pretty straightforward. The search length here, you can see that we've got it set to relatives, so it's going to be relative to the radius of the particles. And I found that the best setting for this simulation is around 3.5 to 5. And max links is just how many links per particle. In this case here, we probably only need 8 to 10, but let's leave it at 16 anyway. I haven't used tension too much here. I know that if you set it too high, you will tend to get your particles exploding away from each other. And if you set it too low, they kind of suck into each other. So I just leave it at 1, and I leave the random to 0. In our case now, we're going to leave the stiffness and the dampening to 1. If you lower these down, you'll get more of a cloth-like feeling to it. You'll get like a lot more folds in the simulation, and the particles will generally look a little bit looser. So let's just leave that here. We're going to set the broken to 5 just to make sure that our particles don't break apart. If we were to leave that, we may get some tears in the links here, so we just want to make sure that that's set high for this one. Alright, we can just leave this at 1, and let's set this to 50% here, and you can see that it says chance of a new link created on a collision, so 50% of the time it will create a new link. And if we were to set this to 100, it would just look a little bit stickier, so this is about the right setting I found for this animation. For our next one, we will be going a little bit higher. Alright, and then again we can leave these both to 1, and let's just set our broken to 5 so that we make sure that our links aren't broken. We just want to move this back a bit, so let's hit GY, and then you can hold shift and just drag the mouse slightly back. And now the particles should be off-centered enough to fall in front. Alright, and then the final thing we want to do before we start our simulation here is add a collision to both of these objects. Alright, so let's go into the physics properties here, and we can click collision. And what we want to do is change the damping to 1 or something very high, just so that our particles don't bounce off of our object here, so it'll help make them look a lot heavier. Now we can click our floor object here. Let's click collision as well, and we're going to do the same thing, change the damping to 1. Alright, now we can click back on our particles here and go back into our particle settings, and then we can just scroll down. Also, we just want to change our mass to 50, which will just help our simulation to look a bit heavier. So scroll all the way down here, and now that we've got everything set, we can hit start molecular simulation, and this should take between a minute and 5 minutes or so, depending on your system. You'll also notice that when it's peaking, it's doing about 10 times as many frames, and I believe that has to do with how many substeps we've put in here, but once it's finished peaking, it will go back to 250. Alright, so now that that's finished baking, we can just click away, and we can hit the spacebar to watch the simulation in real time. And that's looking pretty good. Hopefully yours is looking something like this. It's probably looking a little bit different just because every simulation is a little bit different. And if you're having any weird issues with this, you can reset your transforms by hitting Control A on both of these before you simulate. I didn't do that just because, I don't know, I guess I'm bad. And you'll notice that mine is looking pretty good here. So if you're having any like weird clumping or jittering or holes or anything like that in your particle system, it's probably because you've got your substeps set too low. So just make sure you can go as high as possible with that. And that's it for our first simulation. So you can click on the icosphere here. Let's go to the materials properties, click new. And then we can set the metallic to 1, and you can bring the roughness down to whatever you like. I also changed the particle color to be a little bit darker. And if you're going to stick with Eevee, make sure that you use screen space refractions. Next, we can click our collision object here, and we can click new. Let's set the roughness to 0 and the transmission to 1, and this will give us a nice glass-looking texture. And again, screen space refractions if you're using Eevee. Alright, so now if we click on material preview here, by the way, if yours shows up white or something weird, it could just be loading, and sometimes that can take up to like 2 or 3 minutes, so just give it a minute just to load everything up. Alright, so that's looking good. So now we can go into our render view here, and you can see that nothing's happening. So let's add an HDRI. So let's click on the world tab here, click this little circle here, and we can click environment texture, click open. And if you want to use the same HDRI that I'm using, you can go to the link in the description here and download that, or feel free to pick one of your own. Alright, and then click open. And again, sometimes this can take a couple seconds to load up, so don't panic if it's taking a little bit of time. Alright, so that's looking really good. For my animation here, I use Cycles, so I'm just going to switch over there. And you can see that it's looking really good. You can grab this here and just hit G, X, and just drag it way out of the scene here, just so it's not in our way. And then the final things I did to finish this scene here was add 3 extra lights. So let's just go back into our flat shading here. Hit Shift A and we can go to Cylinder. Next we'll hit S to scale and then Shift Z to lock it to the X and Y axis. And then you can just bring it out to whatever size you want. Hit Tab to go into edit mode or click here. Hit 3 on your keyboard or you can click here to go into face select mode. And we can just select this top face here and hit delete and select faces. Next hit 2 on your keyboard or you can go into edge select here. And if you hold alt and select, it will grab the entire edge loop. Then we can hit G, Z, and we can just bring our mouse up. Alright, and then we can just go to the side here and just select all of these faces here. And we'll just go under and shift select this face to deselect it. And then we'll just hit delete faces. And then the last thing we want to do is just hit Control R and we can click and drag down here and click. Alright, now hit Tab to go back into object mode here. Right click and shade smooth. Hit Shift A, go to light, and we can go to area light here. Let's move to the side here, and then we can just hit G, and then we can just kind of drag our mouse here. Hit S to scale, and just drag your mouse outwards till it's about that size, and then we'll hit R to rotate, X to lock it to that axis, and we can just drag our mouse up till it's on a nice angle. So now that we've got one light here, we can hit Shift D to duplicate it, Shift Z to lock it to the X and Y axis, and then we can just bring it over here. Then we're going to hit R to rotate, Z to lock it to the Z axis, and just turn it with our mouse. And then click. Alright, we'll hit Shift D again, hit X to lock it to the X axis, and we can just drag it over to the other side here. Click. Then we'll hit R, Z again to rotate on the Z axis, and turn it to face our particles. Alright, and the rest is just a matter of taste, so you can go into render preview mode here, click on our first light, and we can go into the properties here. Let's set this to around 1000, and we can change the color to an orange. We can click the one on the side here, let's change this to 1000 as well, and we can change this to a teal. Alright, and we'll just do it to the other light here, so change this to 1000. And set this to a nice teal color. Alright, so if you want to add a camera, hit Shift A. We can go to camera here. And once we've framed up our view, we can hold Control Alt and hit 0. Make sure you're in the camera settings here, and you can type in 35 and hit Enter. Alright, click here to turn off all the guides, and that's our final animation, you'll notice that I also added a couple of spheres in the back. They're pretty basic, just a sphere, and I added the same material as the ground plane. So hopefully that's looking good for you. Let's just go into flat shading again and bring ourselves out of camera view by middle mouse clicking, and we can turn our guides back on. So now we can move on to our second animation. So let's just click here, turn on our viewport toggle here. We can turn off our camera for now by just clicking and dragging. We'll turn off our plane. And we'll also turn off the torus as well. And the reason why we added this in as well is this will turn off the simulation. So if you don't do that, it won't be visible, but it'll still calculate it. So it will slow down your system. So just make sure that you've got these set to off as well. All right, hit Shift A and we'll go to Mesh one more time. Click Circle. Then we can hit G to move it. Set to lock to that axis. And we can type in 10. Hit the decimal key on your numpad to orbit around our object. Hit tab or click here to go into edit mode. Hit A to select everything, and then we can hit F to fill. Alright, so make sure on edge select mode here, we can hit I and just drag our mouse in to add a couple more subdivisions here. And let's do that 3 or 4 times. And click. And if you want to move these, you can hold Alt and click on the edge loop here. Hit G 2 times in a row, and then you'll be able to slide the edge loop along the face. Alright, hit tab to go back into object mode here, and now we can add our particle system. So let's go here, hit the plus one more time to add a new particle system. This time we'll change the number to 3500. We can change the start and end frame to match our timeline here. And we also want to change the lifetime to the length of our animation as well. Let's leave the source to faces here, but we can click random. Move down to velocity here. Let's put in 0 for normal, and we're going to type in -2 for the Z axis. Scroll down. We can leave the mass to 1 this time. Make sure that you open up your deflection settings here and click size deflect again. Scroll down and let's change this to object. And what we can do is just zoom out a bit here. Let's click our original icosphere here, Shift D to make a copy of it, and we can hit X. And then just drag our mouse over a little bit here, and now we've got a second particle. Let's click back on the emitter, hit the decimal key to zoom in. And now we can go down to object here, and we can change our scale to 0.35 and scale randomness to 0.6. And now we can click here, and we're going to go to icosphere.001. Now we can scroll all the way down to molecular here. Let's activate that. This simulation is a little bit more forgiving, so feel free to set this to something lower to speed it up. And we can scroll down here. Let's open the density settings this time, and we'll click calculate particles by weight density. Click here and we'll click sand, and this just gives us a little bit more of a jiggly feeling. All right, again, we're going to activate self collisions here, and we won't need this since we're only using one system. We'll activate particle linking. Set our search size to 3.5. Leave all of this mostly the same except for broken. We'll change that to 2. We can change our linking here to 75%. And just to add a bit more of a jiggle here, we can set both the stiffness and dampening to 0.9, and we'll set the broken to 2. Alright, and then the final thing we can do before we simulate is just click here, and we're going to add some friction to our ground plane so it looks more sticky. So you can add as much as you want, but I'm going to go all the way up to 0.9. All right, and we can just click our emitter one more time, go back into our particle settings here. And then before we start, I just want to lower the stiffness just a little bit. So let's go 0.85, and let's do that for this one as well. And that way it'll just bend a little better and it won't get stuck. And we can also just bring this up, so G, Z, and we can just drag our mouse up a little bit here. And click. Alright, so let's scroll up here to start molecular simulation, and this should only take about 30 seconds to a minute. So now that that's finished, we can play our simulation through, and you can see that there's a little bit of jittering and stuff like that, so if you want to get rid of that, again, like I said, just change the substeps to as high as you can go, and the more you do that, the better it will look. Alright, so now that we've got that finished, the last thing we need to do is add a material to our particles here. So let's click our new particle, go into materials properties here. We can click the X here and add a new material. Let's set the roughness to 0 and the transmission to 1. Now if we unhide our camera here, we can hit 0 on our numpad to go into our camera perspective here, and we can click rendered view. Turn our guides off, and you can see that everything is looking awesome. And for this animation here, all I did was make a duplicate of my particle object here, and I put them kind of along the back here, just because I felt like the background was a little bit plain. And the other thing that I did as well is just add one more cylinder just to encase the top of the object here. And I also added a collision to that object. Alright, so that's everything. I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. I know this add-on has a lot more possibilities, so it's pretty new to me, so I'm going to keep going through it and see what more I can get out of it. Maybe do some sand or something like that. So stick around for that in the future. Alright, thanks again everyone. Bye.